Hello everybody, this is Tiziano, and today we're going to start getting into the world of simultaneous localization and mapping, also known as SLAM. If you haven't seen my previous videos, check out all my tutorial series about ROS, I provided a link in the description below. In the last video, we created a simple DIY LiDAR with a single point laser, rangefinder and a servo. It was fun, but nothing that we can use in a real SLAM calculation. Today, we will start by exploring and setting up this new sensor, the $100 RPLidar A1, that I received from Robot Shop for evaluation. You can find a link in the description below. Then, we will download and configure HectorSLAM and build a quick map of my living room. The RPLidar is a 360 degrees sensor with a maximum range of about 12 meters. The box contains a small box with a few instructions and the cable, a USB adapter, and finally the RPLidar A1. I have to say that it looks and feels very good. It looks really nice and rigid, and you can tell it's made to be integrated on your own platform, as the connector faces the bottom side, so you can plug it on top of your carrier board. If we take a look at the connector we have, the ground for the scanner core, serial RX and TX, 5 volts for powering up the logic, then ground for the motor, the analog control for the motor speed, and the power supply for the motor from 5 to 9 volts that can come from a different source from reducing the noise. Let's get started by connecting the RPLidar to my laptop using the USB adapter. I downloaded the SDK from the Robot Shop website, but you can find it also at slamtech.com. Once unzipped, we navigate into the Tools folder where we install the drivers for Windows. Here, you can find the 32 and 64-bit version. I go ahead and install the 64-bit. Once installed, you should find the adapter in your device manager as Silicon Labs USB to UART bridge. Take note of the COM port and open a frame grabber application. Here, select the proper COM port and leave the default baud rate, then hit OK. Next, we hit the start button on the top left, and here we are in my living room. Pretty neat, I can see part of a corridor on the left, my fireplace on the front, the kitchen on the right, with those little columns over here, and here on a corner, there is me, that's my hand moving around. Actually, let me zoom in. Now we can clearly see a table lamp on my left and my hand waving at the LiDAR. Very, very cool. On the top left, we can see the range at the selected angle and the current update rates and motor speed, while on the right, we have the measured samples per seconds. Enough with Windows, it's time to move to our ROS environment on Ubuntu. In the tutorial, I want to cover two steps. The first is downloading and installing the RPLidar ROS package. The second is having a first glimpse to using the LiDAR for simultaneous localization and mapping, using HectorSLAM. We download the ROS package from GitHub and follow the instructions on the README file. The first step is giving the USB port the authority of writing. In fact, after typing sudo chmod 66 and then the name of the device, that is dev tty-usb0, we have correctly set up the authorization. After that, we just need to download the RPLidar package in our CatKing workspace. So we browse into the CatKing workspace source, and here we clone the repository. Then we go back one folder and we type CatKing make. And let's not forget to source. And now everything is ready to test the RPLidar ROS package. First, we launch the ROS core in one terminal. On the top here, we launch the example file, typing ROS launch, RPLidar ROS, and if I hit tab, we can see multiple files. The one we are interested into is the view RPLidar.launch. The launch file starts the LiDAR node and RVs. On the left, we see that the LiDAR node is publishing on the scan topic. Let's enlarge those dots, setting the sides to 0.08. And here is my living room again. Let's explore the scan topic. If you remember from my previous videos, typing ROS topic list, we have a list of all the active topics. Here we have scan, but we also have TF. Now TF is a very important topic that broadcasts the transformations from reference frames, and we will get back to that in a future video. As we have seen in my video about a DIY laser scanner, the LiDAR uses a message laser scan of the package sensor messages. And here we have the frame it refers to, named laser, the angle range that goes from negative to positive pi, the angle increment of 1 degree, time increment, the time of the entire scan of 150 milliseconds, and the minimum and maximum range of respectively 0.15 and 12 meters. And now it's time for some simultaneous localization and mapping, and for that we'll be using Hector's LAM. Hector mapping is a SLAM approach that can be used without odometry and works great for our example. The image shows all the potential frames of interest in a simplified 2D view of a robot traveling through rough terrain, leading to roll and pitch motion of the platform. Here we have the reference frame of the map, then we have Odom, that's the reference frames of the odometry, then we have the base footprint, that's the projection on 2D, then we have the base link, that's connected with the vehicle, and the base stabilized, that's connected with the vehicle, but it's stabilized with respect to the horizon. And then we have laser link, that's the reference frame of the laser. And this is the reference frame of the LiDAR. We downloaded Hector's LAM ROS package from the TU Darmstadt GitHub repository, and as usual, we make and source the environment. Now we need to change a couple of launch files. For that, I give credit to Nicholas Liu and his great GitHub repository. I put his link in the description below. First, we browse in the Hector Mapping launch folder and we modify the mapping default.launch file. Here, we need to tell Hector's LAM that there's not going to be a base footprint, so basically we are on the ground and flat, and that the base link is actually going to be our odometry frame. So we change the third line, changing the default base frame to base link, and in the next line we change the odometry frame from nav to base link. Then we need to tell where our laser is going to be. This is covered by TF, that will broadcast the relative position and orientation between the base link and the laser frame. So we scroll to the last line and we change the TF broadcast from map to nav into base link to laser frame. After that, we change the tutorial launch file in Hector's LAM, Hector's LAM launch, launch folder. Here, we just change the use sim time to false. That means that we are going to use real time, no simulations. And now we are ready to run Hector's LAM. In one terminal, we launch the RPLidar example. And here on the top, we run the launch file that we just modified for Hector's LAM. And here we go. What you see here is a scan and a first map. As I move the laser, the algorithm will compare the new scans with the old one and will get the most likely map and localization that minimize the error. As I'm walking in the room, the map is complete, and I can save and use it for localization or path planning in the future. Big news, guys! The new shirts are coming! I designed those shirts myself because I want to wear something that reflects who I am, and I'm a constant learner. And you can have those shirts both in white or black. Check out my new store on Teespring right here or in the description below, where you can find also hoodies and coffee mugs and everything else with my life motto: never stop learning.